Hachette Audio presents Middle School, From Hero to Zero. Written by James Patterson and Chris Tebbetts. Read by Michael Crouch. This one goes out to the Londonberries. Barbara, Jan, Joe, Ruth, and Vicky. C.T. Chapter 1. Packing Up. Hello? Hello? Is this thing on? Okay, here we go. Hi, everyone. It's me, Rafe. I don't have a lot of time because in about 5 minutes I have to get in the car, to go to the airport, to get on a plane, to fly to London. Yes, that London. The big one in England. It's a school trip, and we're going to be seeing all kinds of Englishy stuff, like Buckingham Palace, the Tower of London, the Modern Art Museum, and the London Eye, which is like a Ferris wheel made out of space stations on steroids. I'm crazy excited. But you want to know what's even crazier? I am so not packed. And did I mention that I'm leaving in 5 minutes? Here's what I have so far. One very empty suitcase. And way over here, one pile of clothes, shoes, and bathroom stuff. I don't care what I wear in London, as long as I can change my underwear every day. And I need comfortable shoes, too. My art teacher, Ms. Donatello, said we're going to be walking our butts off over there. Well, she didn't really say butts off. My mom gave me £50 of spending money, but that's just what they call money over there. It's not like 50 actual pounds of money. It's more like $50, but I'll take it. Thanks, Mom. If you know me, you know I never go anywhere without my sketchbook. I like to draw as much as I like to eat, which, by the way, is a lot. And I'm borrowing my grandma's phone, too, so I can keep making these videos. Everyone on the trip has to do a report on it, and mine's going to be full-on multimedia, with video, drawing, writing, and I don't even know what else. I guess I'll find out when I get there. Okay, so I better start packing. Next time you see me, I'll be on the other side of the Atlantic Ocean. Well, unless I miss my plane, and then you can forget everything I just said. Wish me luck. Later. Rafe, Mom said you have to leave now. Coming. Did you remember everything? Yes, I remembered everything. Now stay out of my room. What an idiot. Seriously, Rafe? You're already losing things. This trip is going to be one big disaster. I could be wrong, but let's face it, big brother. You're the king of disasters. So good luck. You're going to need it. And watch out, London, because here comes Rafe. Chapter 2. Time to go. At the airport, everything was crazy. There were kids and parents and chaperones trying to find each other, plus half a zillion other people, all traveling in half a zillion other directions. And then there was a little room where we could all finally stop and gather up for our big goodbyes before I had to find the other kids. It was definitely insane. But I could actually start to see the adventure I had been imagining. Excited? Grandma asked me. Yep, I said. But honestly, I was kind of nervous, too. You sure you have everything? Mom asked me. Yep, I said, even though I had this weird feeling I was forgetting something. Are you really sure you have everything? Georgia asked, in that annoying way where you know she's not really asking a question. Then she held up the phone Grandma was lending me for the trip with a really smug smile. Where'd you get that? I asked her. It was sitting on your bed while you were walking out the front door, genius, she said. I told you to stay out of my room, I said, and grabbed it back. When it comes to snooping, my sister has superpowers. And she was definitely going to do some super snooping while I was in London. That's why I'd spent the last week blowing my nose and leaving all the used Kleenex in my desk and dresser drawers. There was also some mega-realistic plastic dog puke on my closet floor, and a note under my mattress that said, "Stop snooping or die!" But that was it. I couldn't worry about Georgia anymore. It was time to go. Mrs. Stricker was yelling at the parents to say goodbye so we could all get ready to hop into the security line, which looked about 2 miles long. "All right, off you go," Mom said, and then walked me a little closer. When it comes to saying goodbye, Mom always likes a little time alone with me. I kind of like it, too.
"This is so exciting! Your first time out of the country without me," she said. "And who would have thought you'd turn into such an international jet-setter? I thought Australia was exciting enough, what with the surfing and drop bears and the bunyip adventure, which I would personally rather forget." She stopped, embarrassed. She was rambling about my last trip abroad. I won a school art competition, and the prize was a free trip to the land down under. Things didn't turn out so well, but I was glad I had the chance to go, even if it did end in disaster.
"You're going to have a great trip, sweetheart," Mom finished.
"Yeah," I said. "I guess so."
"You guess?" Mom said.
"Well,
what is it?" she said.
She can always tell when I'm feeling weird about something. And this wasn't the kind of weird I wanted to put in a video, where everyone would hear about it. But I could tell Mom, even if it came out a little awkward. See, this was supposed to be some great thing, right? I was really lucky to go somewhere as crazy exciting as London. Grandma helped out and got her friends to buy about 20,000 rolls of wrapping paper in our school fundraiser, and I got a scholarship, thanks to Ms. Donatello. But here's the problem. The only real friends I had were staying back in Hills Village, on the wrong side of a pretty huge ocean. That included Flip Savage, the funniest kid I've ever known, and Junior, my dog and best non-human friend. In other words, I was on my own for this trip. Totally friend-free. Which was like going back to the bad old days at Hills Village Middle School, when I was about as popular as Mystery Meat Monday in the cafeteria. It's just, I don't have any friends on this trip, I told Mom.
What about Jeanne Galletta? Mom asked.
Jeanne doesn't count, I said. She's really nice, but it's not like we're actually friends. I probably, definitely, wasn't supposed to like Jeanne as much as I did. But try telling that to my brain. I just couldn't help it. Right now, Jeanne was standing with the rest of the kids, along with her stupid, perfect boyfriend, Jared McCall, who I am not jealous of. It's just that Jared's so good at everything, you kind of want to stick his head in a toilet sometimes.
Well, I see at least one girl looking your way, Rafe. I think you might be more popular with the ladies than you realize.
Don't say ladies, I said. And besides, you're my mom. You have to say that stuff.
How about Ms. Donatello? Mom said. You like her, don't you?
Sure, I said. For a teacher. But that doesn't really count.
Well, here's an idea. Why don't you try making a few new friends? Mom asked me.
That one was harder to answer. I mean, everyone in middle school already knew me. And it wasn't like I'd been sitting on all the good parts of my personality so I could bust them out now and start winning popularity contests. I pretty much knew by now who my friends were and who wouldn't be caught dead talking to me. I didn't know if Mom would understand all that, but I'll bet you do, right?
I guess, I mumbled, which was easier than telling her everything I just told you.
It can't hurt to be friendly, Mom said. I wouldn't want you to spend the whole trip alone with that sketchbook of yours.
She had a point. I did bring my sketchbook, for sure. I love to draw, including my loser comics, which you may already know about. You'll definitely see some more of those later.
Now you better go, or Mrs. Stricker is going to leave without you, she said. Mrs. Stricker is the principal of Hills Village Middle School. She also happens to hate the ground I walk on. Right now, she was evil-eyeing me like I was holding up the whole airport. Sorry, Ida, Mom called out to her. He's coming. Mrs. Stricker mumbled, which I think was something about should have left without him, but I couldn't be sure. Bon voyage, sweetie, Mom said, and gave me one more quick hug for luck. I love you, and remember what I said. I will, I told her. And I would. I'd remember every word, just as soon as I got busy being the least popular kid on that whole trip. Hey, it's a tough job, but someone has to do it. Chapter 3. Introducing Dryden. Hang on. Sure, I was all set to be pretty lonely and awkward, but you don't even know the worst part. Once everyone said goodbye, Mrs. Stricker and the other chaperones got us all standing in one place and started counting heads. We will have 4 daily roll calls on this trip, Mrs. Stricker said. When I call your name, respond with a nice, clear, present. Not, yeah, or huh, or that's me. The proper response is present. Understood? And then she started down the list, checking off names in alphabetical order. Katrina Anderson. Present. Colin Aziz.
Present.
Andrea Chin. Yeah. Present. Then all of a sudden, someone was yelling in the airport. Excuse me. So sorry. Coming through. Excuse me. I looked over and saw this lady running toward us, waving at Mrs. Stricker. Behind her was a man in a suit and tie, carrying a suitcase. They both looked kind of fancy to me, like they belonged on the cover of Whole Lotta Money magazine. But I'd never seen them before. I'm so terribly sorry to be late, the lady said when she got there. Dryden is going potty in the little boy's room, but he'll be right here. Who's Dryden? Someone said behind me. I was wondering the same thing. Was there some little kid coming on this trip? It's almost time for us to be at our gate, Mrs. Stricker said. She had this look on her face like she hadn't gone to the bathroom in a week. I think she was trying to be polite. Yes, 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 the lady said. Again, I'm so very sorry, but I can't tell you how much Dryden is looking forward to this. We took him to Hong Kong last summer, and he...
Here he is, the man in the suit said. Come along, Dryden. Chop, chop.
I'm coming, I'm coming. Keep your pants on, Dad, someone said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.